Well, hello fellow gamers. Yes, I'm back with another ARK Survival Evolved video. And today we will continue on where we left on the last time. Last time I showed you a little bit of my Aztec Pyramid I was building. And in the meanwhile I have been collecting some materials and been building some of the blocks used to continue the build. And that's exactly what we are going to do today. So we will do some building. The goal is to add a new level to the pyramid, but before we start, let's have a look from the top here. As you can see, I have added a lot of foundation, so the floor is completely, well, almost finished by now. I still have to do this little part up there, but that will be for the next time. Meanwhile, I have collected the necessary materials to put a new level up. At least I hope so. I hope my calculations are correct. So let's head over to the other side and have a look at what we need and what we will be doing today. Okay, well, here we are at one of the entrances of my pyramid, and you will notice a few special things here we are running. This server is running some mods. One of them is the corrected structures no collision mod, which allows me to build in places where collision checks wouldn't allow me to build in default with the ARK. One example of that is, for example, let me show you, yeah, right here. This place has a foundation, but half of the foundation is under the floor, just as this place. And even here, I have a foundation which is completely under the floor. This would be possible in vanilla ARK Survival Evolved, but with the mods we have running here, it is possible. One other thing we can do with this mod is build corrected structures like foundations, and those allow you to pick them up again. So once they are built, you can pick up a stone foundation, for example, and replace it. This is quite handy if you place it incorrectly or in the wrong spot. You can always come back and pick it up again without losing your materials, and then deposit it back again. So as I mentioned, I have been collecting all the materials, and I have been building some parts I need. With this corrected structures mod, this is done in the crafting table, and as you can see, I have here corrected stone walls, I have corrected stone foundations, I have quite a few things corrected, fence foundations and corrected dinosaur gates and doors. Some things which I don't have here are the sloped wooden roofs and the sloped walls left and right, and these sloped wooden roofs. These I had to build using the normal ARK Survival Evolved stuff. But as you can see, if my corrections are my calculations are right, I need about 30 of those sloped walls left and 30 right. I think I need about 64 stone walls. I need about 150 stone ceilings and 240 sloped wooden roofs and some foundation fence foundations and gates. I will show you why I need those in the coming few minutes. So maybe it's a good idea to start with some building, and I will speed up the building process so we don't have to watch it all. But I will come back every time I have something special to explain to you. So let's get started with some ceilings. Okay, we are almost at the top of the second floor. I will go up one more level, and the goal is to add those ceilings right here. I will place, let me start here. I will place one here for the corners, and then I should be able to place my ceilings all around this level. I will need one block on every side, and from there on I can continue building all the other things I need. There you go. One more. Let's see if I can reach the end. I think I'm missing a few, but it doesn't matter at all. I will start with one side of the building and then we can continue from there on. I need one more foundation, one more ceiling, I mean. So let's go get that. I will also get a few more, and the dinosaur gates and similar things, so I can continue with that as well. 26 should be enough. I will get two of these, one gate and one door, and we can go up again and place the remaining few blocks here. Okay, I think I was missing one in the corner, so let's go put that one up first. Mm-hmm, here we go. Okay, now my goal is to build this part of the level, which is the entrance. And if I remember it correctly, that's five blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's one on this side. Five blocks, yes. So let's go up and do the same thing right here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I have two blocks this way. Two. And I can go back towards the outer side. So I have now built, let's go down so I can show you. I have now built this part of the ceiling. So these stones here. So the outside actually. And there is a reason why I'm doing that. It's to help myself not make any mistakes. And why could I make some mistakes? Well, I can show you that by getting some walls to start with. Oh. Well, that wasn't a good idea. Let's hope I won't be doing that too often. There are 10 walls, should be enough. Okay, this is a little building tip I have discovered, and probably a lot of you already know that. But when placing walls, let me put my walls on one of my slots here. When placing walls, you see here, you can place walls in different ways. This one will be built on the inside, but what if I want it to build on the outside? You see, this one is built on the inside of the block I'm standing out, and this one will be built on the outside of the next block, the adjacent block. And what I want is to have my walls all on the outside of this block. And the easy way to do that and not have problems with it appearing like this instead of this is by not building this block, actually, by not placing this ceiling or foundation. I am making the system build my walls on the inside of, actually on the outside of this ceiling. So I need one here, I need two here, and I need three here to start. There you go. Similarly on this side, I need three. 1, 2, 3. I need two more here. Oh, I didn't grab enough. So let's go grab some more. I think I need another, well, five should do the trick. So let's go grab five more. Where they are, here. Yep, that's five, that should be enough. Let's go back up and place the remaining walls. Okay, we're almost there. Yep, this is it. I need two more, so let's place those. 1, 2. And now I will need the sloped walls, and I need 1, 2, 3, 4 for each. This will be a lot of running up and down, but I will only build one side of the structure, because the other four are actually exactly the same. And then I will complete it in fast mode and show you the end result afterwards. Here you go. I have five sloped walls now. so I can build the sloped corners on top of the walls. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Let's pick them. Let's use these to start with. Here again, if I had the ceiling on this side, the system would act very strange. Let me show you what I mean. You see, it's building it. You can build it this way or this way, and depending on how you move your mouse, it will switch. And that's because there are two ceilings to which you can attach the sloped wall. And if you only build one part, there is no problem. It can only build it this way. And if it has one on the other side, you see, now I have it correctly. Let me place it. You see, it's very icky. How should I say that? It's strange. It's acting strange. It's difficult to place. This is a correct one. You see, it was green. It was placing it in the correct way, but still it placed it in the wrong way. And in order not to have that, I noticed that not building the other ceiling solves the problem. I don't have any issues when I do that. So let me put all four up now. Yep, that's it. And the same thing on the other side. Okay, four more here. One, two, three, four. And once this is done, it's completely safe to fill the rest up with ceilings if I want to. So let me fill everything up with ceilings. Yep. Two more. Here we go. Now it's this side is almost ready. The next thing to do is place the dinosaur gateway. But as you can see, this will be very tricky if you want to place it like that. You would have to go into K mode and have really look at how it is placed to make that be correct. But there is another solution to this problem, and that is by placing the fence foundations first, then the gates frame or the gateway will snap to those fence foundations. So let me put up the fence foundations. Yes, this should be okay. Another fence foundation here, and now I can place my gateway and it will snap to those fence foundations. Let me show that. Yeah, let's go closer. You see, it's immediately snaps to the foundations, fence foundations, which, well, helps me place it correctly. One problem, you will keep seeing these fence foundations, of course, and if you try to demolish the fence foundations, the gateway will fall down as well. But I don't mind the fence foundations being there. It has a little thing sticking out at the bottom, which I will show you later on. But I don't mind that. You'll see. Now, the gate has been placed, which is perfect, and it looks just as I expected it. My next step is now to build the sides, the corners, and if my calculations are correct, these should be 2x2, since the previous ones were 3, I believe. The bottom one has 4 walls standing up, and the next one 3, so this one should have 2 walls in the corner. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, I'm trying to explain these walls. So here I have 3 walls and 4 high, and it makes a corner 3 walls, 4 high. This bottom part has 4 straight walls on each side, so the next one should have 2, so it gets a little bit smaller with every step. And how do I do that? Well, I use a similar approach to what I've been explaining up until today. I place my ceilings first, and I don't place all ceilings. I just place the ones where I want to have my walls attached to first. And this solves the problem of having my walls attached to the wrong ceiling. So let's get started. go. Okay, every corner has 5 blocks first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So once the 6th one, I can place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this should be exactly at the same spot as right there, which is correct. So from here on, I can use 2 more ceilings. And the same on this side. 2 more ceilings. Yes, on the 3rd, we can go back to the outside of the structure. And if my calculations are correct, that should leave about 7 sloped ceilings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think I made a mistake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, I did make a mistake somewhere. Well, we will see what happens when we continue. Okay, well, I'm back. I know what I did wrong. I just placed 1 too many. So luckily I have the corrected structures, so I can go ahead and pick this one back up. This one too. And this one too. I just need to pay attention that I don't fall off. Okay, and this one too. That's correct. And I should have built them right here instead. That seems to be correct. Same here. 1, 2, which looks perfect to me. Here we go. Now let's go fetch some of my walls. I don't have any anymore, so I will have to go down and pick up some more walls. Okay, I need, well, let's pick 20 walls. 5 of these. That way I'm sure I have enough stuff to build. And let's go back up. Okay. Now it's the same situation here. I want to build my walls out, so I should place my walls on my hotkey. Here you go. And since I have only one side with ceilings, I have no problems again with placing them correctly. 2 and 3. Okay, that's fine. And now I said 2 blocks for the corners. And here I will have to pay attention. Okay, it places correctly. Let's finish this one. Oh. Okay, one more. Okay, I have no more walls now, but that doesn't matter at all. What I need to do now is place those sloped walls. I think it will be these. No, I'm incorrect, but it doesn't matter. We can show. No, not this one. It will be the other ones. Made a little mistake, but doesn't matter at all. Here, one sloped wall, another sloped wall. Another sloped wall, and the last sloped wall will go up there. Seems perfect to me. Yes. Absolutely perfect. Now I can go down and go pick up some sloped wooden roofs to finish up that part of the building. Okay, let's place some stuff back in there. Here we, yeah. And what I need now is, I believe, 24 of these. 21. 7 times 4 is 24. Okay, let's go back up. And the thing we are building now is these ramps we are walking on. So, let's try that out. I will place them on my hotbar for place it, which seems to be okay. And as I mentioned, I should have 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. And now we can continue with the others. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 2 more layers. Maybe I can do them both at once. The only thing I need to be careful about is not to fall down, because if I fall down from this height, I will surely die. But I just have to pay attention. A little bit two more. Oh! Of course, 7 times 4 is 28, not 24, so I'm missing 4 more sloped stone roofs. Let's grab 4 more. There we go. And let's place the missing 4 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect, perfect, really. What I can do now is finish up this part here. Let's place some more ceilings, since now it's no problem at all if I have ceilings on this side. I finished my building anyway. Okay, one more. And a few more here. And what I could do next is close up everything up here. There you go. So I now have one corner done. I could continue with the same thing on the other side, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. I might continue building and speed up the whole thing, so you have a little montage of my building, and then I will come back once everything is done and I will show you the end. Okay, let's have a look from this side, because that's the only side which is completely finished. As you see, the new level is a little bit smaller than the previous one. The ramps are a little bit less wide than the previous level, but it's starting to look good actually. Let's go a little bit further up so we can see it better. Just have to pay attention that I don't press the wrong button now. There we go. Okay, that's about it. We have added a new level to it. It's not completely finished yet. We still need to fill up the corners with ceilings and have a few walls to put in the corners as well. But apart from that, we did pretty well. It's starting to look pretty nice, if I say so myself. And well, next up we have to add one more level. And once that is done, I think I will have to build a little 9x9 or 10x10 vault area on top. And then it will be finished and we will start decorating, maybe do the inside, maybe do the outside. It's still a big question if I will be able to finish this build on this server. Well, this server is a community server and we have some new rules in place with regards to number of dinosaurs and size of the buildings. And well, I have to admit my building is rather big, especially for a solo player. And well, chances are I will have to break it down because, well, this size of building is actually more for a tribe with five players. And since I'm solo, I have to adhere to the rules or, well, make it smaller. But that's something we will see in the future. I hope I will be able to finish the build before they will take everything down, or I will take everything down. So at least I can show you the finished picture when it's ready. But until then, I hope you enjoyed this little building movie. I know it's it can be rather boring to watch people build, but I hope you learned a few things from this building episode. And feel free to comment on the video if you liked it, share it, press the thumbs up button. And I hope we will see each other again in another gaming video, maybe even an ARK Survival Evolved video. Hope to see you soon, guys. Have fun and stay safe. Bye.